Hallelujah. 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 The word of God gives us comfort. It tells us that we do not mourn like those that don't have hope. We know if you knew Darrin, you knew that he was a servant. You knew that he was a believer. You knew that he loved God. And based on that fact alone, we've come to celebrate. I said, based on that fact alone, we've come to lift up the name of Jesus. Why? Because we know he's in a place that we're trying to get to. The word of God declares that to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Do you believe the word? I said, do you believe the word? Do you really believe the word? Yes, Lord. He's in the place that we're trying to get to. And so today we just come to celebrate his arrival home. Amen. And the good news is that we're going to see him again. Amen. 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 Today, amen, we've come to celebrate the life of this great young man. Amen. We've come to celebrate, amen, the lives that he's touched. Listen, his journey speaks for itself. Amen. But today, this is a celebration, amen, of the young man that we've all come to know and love. You're going to think about the last time that you saw him. You're going to remember the last conversations that you had. You're going to think about all of those things. But this is what I want you to do. When that thought crosses your mind, I just want you to lift your hands and tell God, thank you for allowing you to have encountered the gift that we all knew in Darrin. Can you do that for me today? I said, can you do that for us today? Amen. All of us are mourning together, so it's going to take a collective strength to get through this moment. It's going to take our collective strength, amen, to endure this hard situation. But I believe that the strength of God is going to see us through it. Yeah. Amen. We have a program that has been so beautifully outlined. Amen. And we're going to follow it to the best of our ability. Amen. But I'm expecting God at any moment to send his spirit. Amen. And to shadow and to just comfort us with his strength. Amen. I'm looking for God to show up. Amen. The one thing that I've come to know and appreciate about Darrin is that Darrin, like myself, was a praiser. I said, Darrin, like myself, was a praiser. And the one thing that us praisers are a little guilty of is that sometimes we kind of forget where we are, and we forget that there's a script that we're supposed to follow and all of that. And when we get to thinking about how good God has been, we just have a tendency to praise him. And so that was the thing that united me with Darrin, because Darrin had the audacity to mess up any service he was in. Y'all would be sitting here looking cute like this and looking well put together. And you know, we come to services and y'all don't like to praise him until somebody started off. But Darrin didn't have a problem. He did not have an issue with messing up your role, disrupting your section, doing whatever he had to do to make sure God knew that he was grateful for the life that he had. Now listen, I'm not going to try to lead you to a place you don't want to go, but I'm telling you, like Darrin, I'm a praiser. So I want you to know that when I think about how good God's been to Darrin, and when I think about how good God's been to me and all the rest of those of us that are in here, I'm telling you, I'm not going to mess with you. But if I just tip off to the side and give my God a little bit of praise, I just want you to do it. I'm only doing what my brother would do. I'm only doing what Darrin would do. I said, I'm only doing what any believer would do. Amen. In the worst of times, it's the best of times to give him praise. I said, in the worst of times, it's the best of times to lift him up. In the worst of times, it's the best of times to put on a praise. Why? Because he told us that he gives us the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. And I'm not going to act like I got it all together. Listen, I cry tears, but the one thing that I know I can put on today is the strength of God. So when I feel myself getting a little weak, Today. Amen. That's what we came to do, is to celebrate a life well lived.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Listen, we're going to receive this praise team who's going to lead us. And then after that, we're going to have the prayer of comfort by Apostle Thomas Wrigley. And then we're going to have the reading of the scriptures, the old and the new, by Elder Jonathan Jones and Elder Dominique Williams. We're going to receive them in that order of the praise team.
To every tribe we're in.
Amen. Somebody shout, we win. We win. Now listen, I'm going to help some of you all out because I can see you scratching your heads trying to figure out why we're making some of the declarations that we're making. I hear you saying, how could you say that we win in a moment like this? I made a statement earlier and I told you that Darrin lived. A life well lived. And I can hear you saying, well, it seems like the time was cut short, man of God. How can you say he lived a life well lived? And then we were praising. And while we were praising, I saw some of you saying, here they go shouting again, and here they go doing all of that again. But listen, I'm going to help y'all so that we can go ahead and get past this moment. Can I do that? You need to understand the reason why we can say that he lived a life well lived is because living and having a well life is not based on the length of your life. Mm-hmm. It's based on the quality of your life. Mm-hmm. There are some people that live 100 years old and live and lead raggedy lives. But Darrin, in this short amount of time, lived a great life. Love a lot of people. That's a life well lived to me. A life well lived. He did a good job with what he had. Why y'all doing all that dancing and praising and all this type of stuff? You gotta let people process. Yeah, that's true. That's true. But what I've learned in these little 36 years of my living, Dominique, is that praise helps you deal with the present. He sends his peace to help you with the process. But that praise helps you right here in this difficult moment. And sometimes you just need a little strength to get through right where you are. That's what the praise is. And then the praise team came. Pastor, they said, we win. Why do we win? Why? And how could Darrin have won in this situation? Well, the truth of the matter is that Darrin is a believer. Mm-hmm. Darrin has not lost anything. The Bible tells us that, listen, that to live is Christ, but to die is what? Darrin is already at a place of victory. It ain't no more hurting. It ain't no more sorrow. It ain't no more pain. He don't got to fight the battles that we got to face. Don't have to deal with the hurts and the disappointments that we're wrestling with. He's already on the other side. Well, victory is already ours. That sounds like a winner to me. Sounds like he's winning to me. We still got to hurt and we got to jump. Still got to praise, we got to bear. But damn it, it's only in the winner's circle. Enjoy the victory of the Lord.
Because you are a God that cannot make a mistake. We thank you on tonight, God, that all things have worked together for the good of them who love the Lord and who are the called according to your purpose. We thank you that even in the midst of mourning, you've given us the ability to shift our mourning into dancing. We thank you, hallelujah, that you've given us peace that surpasses all understanding, that will guard our heart and our mind unto Christ Jesus. We thank you that even in the midst of not understanding, you sent the wind of anointing in this house to lift our spirits. We thank you for being the comforter that you that as he's living in the presence of the Lord, that you have given us a glimpse of the experience during this service. Let your power fall in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your glory fall in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your presence arrest us in the mighty name of Jesus. Send us in this place. Deliver us in this place. Heal us in this place. Set the captive free in this place today. And most of all, we declare and decree that you will send a word in the mighty name of Jesus, that you will strengthen the man of God today to preach with power and with demonstration. We thank you now that burdens are lifted. We thank you now that chains are destroyed. And most of all, we thank you now that lives will be saved. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Chapter to start at the first verse. And scripture reads, "Man is the bone of a woman, is of a few days and full of trouble. He comes forth like a flower and is cut down. He fleeth also as a shadow and continues not. And dost thou open thy eyes upon such a one and bringeth me unto judgment with thee? Who can bring a clean thing out of an unclean? Not one. Seeing his days is mine, and the number of the months are with thee, thou hast appointed his bounds that he cannot pass. Turn for him that he may be rest, he may rest till he shall accomplish his and hireling his day. For thou hast the hope of a tree, if it be cut down, that it be sprouted again, that the tender branch thereof will not cease. Though the root thereof wax old in the earth, and the stalk therefore die in the ground, yea, though the scent of the water, it will bud and bring forth a plant. But man dieth and wasted away. Yea, man giveth up the ghost, and where is he? As the water fills from the sea, and the flood decayeth the dried up, so man layeth down and rise not till the heavens have no more. They shall not wake nor be risen out of their sleep. Oh, that thou wouldst hide me in the grave, that thou knowest thou would keep it my secrets until thy wrath be past, that thou wouldst appoint me at a set time and remember me. Verse 14, if a man died, shall he live again? All the days of my appointed time would I wait till my change come. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be unto God.
Corinthians 15, verse 50. Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet will sound, and the last dead will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must be put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible has put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. Mm-hmm. O death, where is your sting? O Hades, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be unto God.
Amen. Come on, everybody, tap your hands for the word of the Lord. At this time, Sister Denisha McClain is coming. I might butcher your name. We come on for you, lady. She's coming
to God. Be all the glory. Yeah. I give honor to God. He is the almost 40. Mm. We've done music together. We've been in so many places. We were like freaking friends. Darrin was the hype, he was the hype man. I was the instigator.
Right.
And we ran real well together. That was my brother indeed. He was the only man, the only boy that my mom would let me spend a night over. Miss Paulette would say, Michelle, when she called, Danche is fine. Mm-hmm. I'll send her on. And when we got put out Miss Paulette's house, we would run to my grandmother's house and we just keep going places until we got put out. Mm-hmm. This is hard. It's really hard, but I love him. And you're absolutely right, man of God. He would have wanted a praise party. And I'm so grateful that I can witness that you all are giving him exactly what he would require. Mm. I won't be long. I'm total praise. Lord, I will lift mine eyes to the hills. No. Is
who is he? He's the King of Kings, he's the Lord of Lords. He's our God, and we bless his name. Listen, at this time we give honor to every ministry gift that have gathered to lend their support, their energies that have come to help pray, come to help praise, come to help to process this difficult moment. We thank you for your gathering to be with us during this time of bereavement. At this time, we're receiving our very own apostle, the one who labors over this leader as he labored over Darren's life. This mighty woman of God, this vessel, the Apostle Susie E. Jones, is coming to give us words of encouragement. Won't you clap your hands and receive her at this time?
Praise the Lord, everybody. To this family, to the ministers, the bishops, apostles, to this church family. It's at this time when one of our loved ones gone on to be with the Lord. The only script, the only comfort, the only thing we can rely on is the Word of God. Yes. There is no one way that we go through grief. There's no one way we process it, because we all have different relationships, and there's a closeness that some have that others don't have. But this young man played a really important role at the City of Champions, which is where I met him. On November, I believe it was 14th of this year, he came to the Ministry of New Life to celebrate the birthday celebration of Pastor Claudio Jones. And he was with Pastor Marshall. And the whole time he was with Pastor Marshall, he was serving. I'm saying November, this is the 1st of January. He was serving as though there was nothing wrong with him. And every time I saw him, he served to the fullest of his ability. And I'm saying that to say, according to the 3rd chapter of the book of Hebrews, it talks about the faithfulness of Jesus Christ. It talks about the faithfulness of hearing the word of God and staying the course. And I believe that all of us have been born with an assignment. And God expects us, Jesus expects us to be faithful, and he's our example. And I believe that this young man came along, and once he put his hand to the plow, he did not look back. And he was faithful in serving, and he did everything that he found that needed to be done. And I say to you this afternoon that although we are going to miss him, the Bible tells us that when we die as believers, we are in the presence of the Lord. Yes. And I just believe that where he is now, he wouldn't come back if he could. Right. So I say to you this afternoon that we take the example that he left, and we fill in the gap. And we do what he did do to serve at the City of Champions. Take that as an example as to where we are to go. Because even in the book of the fourth chapter of the book of Hebrews, the scripture lets us know that Jesus says that there's nothing that we can go through that he has not already felt or gone through. And so since he's already gone through it, he has provided a way for us to get through it. So I say to you this afternoon that we, in the midst of the pain and the sorrow that you're feeling, I suggest to you that following today, after today, that for each step you take, you look up to the hills from where cometh your help. All of your help comes from the Lord. And for each step you take, you say to the Lord, even in this, I trust you. Because I believe that this was ordained by God. He was God's chosen vessel for what he was assigned to do. And God invested in him. And when he got ready for his investment, he came back. He came to pick it up. He came to get it. His assignment was completed. He fought a good fight.
We can make an example from his life, and I encourage you to finish your course, fight a good fight, and stay the course. Stay in the Word of God, and if you stay with Jesus, he'll help you to get through, and we'll make it all the way. God bless you.
Amen. Such powerful words of wisdom from our leader. Amen. We thank God for Apostle Susie B. Jones again. Listen, at this time, the program calls for words of expression. Amen. And they've been outlined already. There's an unable to pray, Evangelist Stacy Haywood, who is Darren's godmother. Dina K, Cooper E.J. Taylor, Kato Mills, which are best friends. And so if you're here, prepare yourself to come in that order as they're getting ready. I'll take this really. I was at a funeral a few moments before this one. And I was there, and there was another young person who passed under tragic terms. We were there, we were celebrating this life system. And it started at 12, and I knew that I couldn't stay for the entire service. So the leader who I was there with, I walked up to the podium and I told him, I said, listen, I have to leave. I have to be at a program at 2 o'clock. And the leader looked at me, not even really realizing what he said. And he said, okay. He said, I understand. He said, it's all right to leave when you have somewhere to go. And I walked to my car and I sat down, brother, and I sat in my car, and the words hit me like a ton of bricks. It's all right to leave when you got somewhere to go. Listen, I know some of y'all are sitting here like me. Sometimes I don't deal with death well, especially when it's a young life. And as I drove all the way, those words brought me comfort. But the Lord spoke to me through the voice of that leader and said, Dante, you got to let the audience know that it's all right to leave when I got another place I got to. Listen, when I got another destination, it's all right to go. Yet they might not understand it. They're going to wrestle with my leaving. But it's all right anyhow, because I've got somewhere I've got to go. Listen, we're receiving your hearts at this time. Amen. We're going to receive our favor to pray. And after that, the rest of God, the ones in that order.
There are many stories I could tell you. I could share with you today. However, I'm going to just tell you just one. The one that I want to share with you today, as I grew up in the New York City area, along with my two nephews there, there was many times when we would come from church and I would see Darrin playing church. He would be playing church, he wouldn't even let it go. So I knew that at the end of the world, at the end of the day, he would be referred to as Minister Darrin Bruton. I want my nephew to know that he is going to be missed by his family, but the life he lived will forever be in our hearts. To my nephew, you will be welcomed home by your mom, my sister Paulette, by your dad, Paul, by his brother, Rashawn, by his grandparents, and all the others in his family. They will welcome him home with open arms. They will say, sit down and come on in. Come on in and have a seat. Come on in, have a seat, Daddy. Your job is well done. The life that you lived was faithful to whatever was put before him. Rest in peace, my nephew. We love you with a big heart. We will miss you from my family.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Like Aunt Mabel, I could stand here and tell you story after story. I met Darrin. He was 19 years old. And he came to the church. He came to Mount Calvary. And out of all the people there, some kind of way, he connected with me. Well, he connected with me, but what I didn't know was, along with Darrin, was about 30 other individuals that were between the age of 18 and 19. Because he sang with the Kinston Community Choir. And so when Darrin was in Raleigh, he was my babysitter. They would leave Central on Friday, and they wouldn't go back to school until Monday. And the whole weekend, I would have a house full of kids. And I would tell Darrin and Don Shay that they used to torture my kids. I was amazed. I knew that Darrin was wonderful with hospitality, because anybody that knows this guy, you know that he had a heart of gold. But what I was amazed at was when he told me that he was working in the food industry at the airport. And I said, Darrin, you're doing what? Darrin, there's no way anybody's letting you work in the food industry. They would bake cookies at my house on the weekend, Pastor. They would burn the cookies because they couldn't cook. And then they would make my children eat the cookies that they burned. And he and Don Shay would go back and forth about who burned the cookies when I got home. And so, yeah, she would always say that he was my pick and he was my favorite. And I never would side with her. And I would always say, Don Shay, you know you burned those cookies. You know that you burned those cookies. But when I met him at 19, he made sure that Miss Paulette and I connected. And when I talked to her, I would not love him more if I had birthed him myself. And for people that had never met me once he got to Atlanta, I'm telling you, he would say, Cato, my mom traveling, she need a room.
He would make everybody take him up when she came to Atlanta. Everybody. Tony, he was like, Ma, Tony, back at the hotel, make sure you go over there and you take care of my mom. I mean, these are people that I never had the opportunity to meet. But that was the kind of guy that he was. And in my closing, let me say this. If Darrin loved you, you knew it.
Mm-hmm.
If Darrin didn't fool with you, he made, see, some of y'all, we gotta guess whether you like me or not. Some of y'all, we not quite sure. Darrin, you didn't even have to ask anybody. He would say, Ma, because nobody could call me Ma like he could. He would say, Ma, I don't fool with them. Ma, I don't fool with them. And I said this privately to Pastor Marshall and First Lady Marshall, and I want to say it publicly. Thank you for loving my guy. And anybody that knows Darrin, and at one time they tried to call him Dee Dee, and like my mind just flipped all the way out. And he's like, okay, Ma. And I was like, no. And I had the opportunity when I met him, I had the opportunity to prophesy to Darrin at the Civic Convention Center at Pastor's Conference. And I said, Darrin, you're gonna preach the gospel. He said, go ahead, girl, go ahead, girl, I don't wanna hear that. And I was like, okay, you don't have to believe me, just remember I said it.
Mm-hmm.
And so when he called me to say, I'm preaching my initial sermon, he said, don't start, Mom. So I saw a few months ago that he posted that he was getting ready to preach his initial sermon. And so I called him and I said, Darrin, didn't we already do this? And he said to me, Mom, I needed to do it over because I needed to do it right this time. So when this happened, all of those things came back to my mind. You're making preparation. You're making sure that your heart is fixed and your mind is made up. And he said to me, I had to do it over because I had to do it right this time. And in our last conversation, he said, Mom, I just been trying to walk upright before the Lord. He said, and for the last 7 years, he said, Mom, I'm telling you, for the last 7 years, I've done everything I could for God to be pleased with my life. So on today, with a broken heart, all I can say is he did a job well done.
Mm-hmm.
He loved City of Champions.
Yes.
He loved City of Champions.
Yes.
He would be like, don't talk about my church. Don't mess with my pastor. I'll get you together about my first lady. Anywhere, he was consistent. He was consistent, and I love him. Even in this, I love him. And God is well pleased. God bless you.
Amen.
Together. And then 4 years ago, I had moved because I started traveling with my job. Then. So when I called Darrin, I said, Darrin, guess what? I started moving back to Atlanta in April. And he was so excited about me moving back. And he was like, you got a job for me? I was like, well, I don't know what's open yet. I said, but give me a little time. So then in July, something came open and I was praying to build a good team. And you know, to take a little stress off of me from work. And I was like, God, you know, who to hire? You know, I cannot keep continuing with this high turnover and all that good stuff. So I heard the Spirit tell me to call Darrin. Mm-hmm. So that's what I did. I picked up the phone and I called Darrin. He was so excited and he took on the opportunity. He came and, you know, worked for me with the Standard State of America as one of my general managers. And, you know, it just was a pleasure, you know, meeting Darrin. And I meant the word to Darrin and Darrin meant the word to me. And, you know, my heart is broken. I know all this well. I'm gonna miss Darrin, but I'm gonna keep it together because I can hear him now. I'm just gonna do that and, you know, continue on living right and continue praying. You know, I'll see Darrin on the other side.
I had the privilege of knowing Darrin for over 26 years. Shortly after we met, within 3 months, he already became my brother. Darrin was the person I can tell everything to. He will always be there for me. And we do anything for you that he can. When his mother died, at her going away service, I promised her that I would take care of Darrin. When Darrin wasn't feeling well, I had no problem taking care of him. Because he loved me and I loved him. And I knew he was a man of God. And that's what God put us together for. For the rest of my life, I will always have a place in my heart for Darrin and Dion. Thank you.
Darrin was my brother. And I knew I loved him to pieces, and I loved him. And he took care of me, and I tried to take care of him. Three things. Mad with him, and I'm gonna be honest. And he messaged me, and he said, "Can you bring over my son?" I said, "Why do you want me to bring over your son?" Because I just want it to be right. And I said, "Okay." I ran over, I sent it back, I said, "Well, Darrin, it was fine." And he said, "Okay, sis." And he said, "You know, I just want to be perfect for God. How many of us want to just be perfect for God? Think about your life now and what you're doing." And then the next thing I said, "But Darrin, how you going to worry and you preaching about faith?" I said, "Sister, you got me together." The other thing was, when he was in the hospital, I watched him. And he said, "Lord, I thank you." And I said, "Wow." Darrin made a choice to praise God despite how he felt, despite how his body was treating him, despite of, he made a choice to say, "Lord, I thank you." Yeah. The last one, yesterday, as we were sitting in the room, I said, "Darrin, I'm mad at you." And I heard his voice say, "Sister, don't be mad at me." I had to go. Mm-hmm. I thank God for Darrin. Y'all keep praying, keep living, keep giving God praise. Despite of what it may look like, despite of not having money in your account, despite of the bills being paid and you don't know how it's going to get paid, despite of your body just not doing what it's supposed to do, despite of your friends turning their backs on you,
keep giving God praise. Keep giving God praise. Amen.
Well,
sorry. Pastor.
Amen. Can we clap our hands for these beautiful remarks? I was listening to his aunt and I could tell where Darrin got his poise was speaking from in his class. And it was so beautiful to hear how they celebrate this life. Because there's something I can identify. You know, servants will make you mad. You've been saying that David is a servant. He was a servant. And everybody, you know, praises a servant. But servants will, they got the way of getting up under your skin. They'll make you real mad.
Yeah.
And you take that from the life of Jesus. Jesus was our perfect example of a servant. But Jesus was talking to his disciples and was telling them about a choice that he was about to make. And I believe it was Peter that rebuked him. Why are you talking about that? You making decisions that are contrary to what we think and we feel. But Jesus knew that as a servant, it was his role to put others before him. I think about Darren's story and his life, and all I can think about is the countless ways that he put others before himself. Even making decisions that we wouldn't have made. We was telling him, Darren, don't do that. You need to do this. Why are you doing that? And I can look at Darren and picture him saying, I'm a servant. I'm putting others before me. And so while many of us may not understand, we may be upset. We may be trying to come to grips to why we're sitting here today. Just know that he was a servant that made a decision. You may not understand it, but it made sense to him. Amen. And he did exactly what he was assigned to do. Amen. Acknowledgements. At this time, we're going to receive Elder Jones and Jones at this time, and they're really going to receive acknowledgements.
Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord.
I stand to give remarks on behalf of the City of Champions, Full Gospel Church, with our pastors, no other, Pastor Jonathan Marshall,
mm-hmm.
and First Lady Carolyn Marshall. Ask that the members of the city will stand this time. All the past former members should also stand. We honor this family because you allowed Darrin to be a part of our lives. He was a member of the city. He loved the city. Everything about the city was, everything about the hospitality of the city was about what Darrin was given to us. And as a church family, it's difficult, but we know that the strength that he brought into the room, we will take from this place and take us to a new generation and to a new presence. You can be seated. I've known Darrin for 21 years. Kato, you've known him for 25. I've known him for 21 years. And it seemed like our paths crossed so many times. I met Darrin in high school. We went to, been up at the same college. We ended up working at the airport together. Mm-hmm. Then we became members of the same church. And I was like, what? Wait a minute now. Our lives are so connected. And it has been my honor and my privilege to not just be the held elder of the City of Champions and being able to serve with Darrin. It's been my privilege to help walk him through ministry. Darrin was a true example of a minister of God. He walked the walk, he acted the act. When it's time to do something, he's the first one to jump. When it's time to get things done, he was the first one to move. Darrin will always be like, hey, we need to clean the church. Who cleaned the church this week? Mm-hmm. He would send out the email, he would send out the text message. All right, now y'all, this church need to be cleaned, so y'all make sure y'all clean the church. So he was that driving force that kept us moving. And we're going to miss that part of him, but we know that God is going to keep us. There's some folks here from that went to North Carolina Central with Darrin. If you can stand, please, those who... It was an honor to be an Eagle. It was an honor to soar high and to know that God has taken us to a higher place. So as an alumni of North Carolina Central University and all the other alumni here, we also give our condolences to the family on behalf of North Carolina Central University. I'll leave you one story. My senior year at Central, my mom passed away during my senior exams. I didn't know what I was going to do. I came back, I told everybody who was in the choir with us that, you know, mom passed away, I'm going, I'm not going to be able to finish my exams. And they was like, okay, well, we're going to come, but you know, people tell you they're going to be there, but you don't know, you just know, okay, yeah, you say you're going to be there. The service started in the middle of service. 20 people that I went to school with walked in that door, and Darrin was one of them. Mm-hmm. And to this day, I am honored to call him a friend. I'm honored to call him a brother. I'm honored to be one who have elevated him in ministry, because he is a man of honor. And we thank God for the life of Darrin Dion Bruton. Mm.
Much. I know he passed on Thursday, but on Tuesday, Pastor Marshall, I said, Pastor, please tell Darrin something for me. He said, hold on, I'm running up the steps. He went up the steps, and he said, Mother, I'm up here. I said, Darrin, I love you. He said, I love you too, Mom. I loved him so much. He was such a good young man. And I'm a funny woman. I don't just like everybody, but God's working on that too. But I love Darrin so much. That's the only thing I can say about him, is that he was a great guy. And most of the people in that church, I love the City of Champion, my pastor, and my overseer, Susie Jones. I just want to say thank you, Jesus, for having Darrin there with us. I can't be happier that I knew him and he was in my life. Thank God.
I can't give you the church resolutions for a future church. Darrin Bruton. Okay. All right. My voice is a little loud, you know, so I'm just going to use this for Jay. Oh, death, where is thy sting? Oh, grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is law. But thanks to be to God, which giveth us the victory through the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15:51-57. Whereas, in the providence of God, he has brought an earthly life for our brother, Minister Darrin Bruton, to close. We, the officers and members of the Cathedral of Prayer International Covenant Church, Bowie, Maryland, feel that it is befitting to express our sympathy during the passing of our dearly beloved. Whereas Minister Bruton has confessed to Jesus Christ as his personal Savior, he joined the City of Champions Full Gospel Church under the leadership of Pastor Jonathan Marshall and served faithfully for the past 7 years as an adjutant and administrative assistant to his pastor. We watched Minister Bruton serve without complaint, even when he was unable to do so. Whereas Minister Bruton is an example for not only a servant, but a warrior that has proven to all strength and preservation, his servitude was admired and his praise was contagious. To be the rest resolved, we add bowing in humble submission to him, whoever made the mistake to remind his family to be encouraged by 1 Corinthians 15:54. To be further resolved that a copy of this resolution will be given to the family and a copy kept for our archives. Humbly submitted, Pastor Wendy Buckman, and Thomas Wrigley, presiding bishop. That's the first one we got a lot. Because he was loved. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The next one. This one comes from Bethesda, all right. Temple International Church, in love and memory of Minister Darrin Dion Bruton. Though your days among us were too brief, and our grief at your loss is never ending, we draw comfort from the knowledge that we have found safe refuge in the Lord, in our hearts where no dark or no pain can touch now. We bless you with love, light, and gratitude. Whereas Minister Darrin Bruton, the City of Champion Full Gospel Church, passed from his life on December 26, 2019. Whereas the death of Darrin Dion Bruton does not diminish the profound dedication of the life lived for such godly service, nor the admiration or an affection of Minister Darrin Bruton's example. Darren's faithfulness, attendance to God, most urgent, we're gonna skip that. God ain't done with these church words, right? All right, amen. Following the footsteps of the righteous, seek justice in all circumstances, and there are the least among us as we are, we're dearest. And whereas Darrin is an active member of the City of Champions Full Gospel Church community for many years, he shared a well, bright, and steady spirit and a cheerful heart. And whereas our beloved Darrin embraced the legacy of faith and service will continue to inspire his loved ones and every member of the clergy. Now, therefore, be it resolved that all the wishes for all those now in mourning to take comfort in the immortality words of the great poet. If I would indeed behold the spirit of death, open your heart wide upon the body of life. For life and death are one, even in the river and the sea are one. Breath from the restless tides, and it may rise and expand and seek God. And when the earth shall calm your limbs, then shall your dance truly. This one is submitted by Apostle Avery Cotton, Senior Pastor. The Cathedral of Hope Ministry, to the pastor and Lady Jonathan Marshall in the City of Champions Full Gospel Church, and to the family of the late Minister Darrin Bruton. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give upon you, as tonight the word given, give I unto you. Let not be your heart troubled, neither be afraid, John 14:27. We, the membership of the Cathedral of Hope Ministry, wish to express our heartfelt sympathy in the homegoing of your loved one, Minister Darrin Bruton. Our hearts go out to you during this time of bereavement. Yet we must not grieve without hope, for we wait the days to great rejoicing. When God's children all get together and they rejoice in the heavens of God. While the hurt, those left behind take comfort in knowing Minister Darrin Bruton is resting in the arms of Jesus. Darrin lives not only for our memories, but he is with our Heavenly Father as well. In times like this, we encourage you. Rely upon the Word of God to strengthen you, comfort, and peace. We have assurance that the ultimate end is not dealt with eternal life.
Mm-hmm.
Be assured that we will withhold you in our prayer and stand ready to assist you in any way that we can. Therefore, on behalf of myself, Lady Vanessa Poole, and the Cathedral Hope Ministry, we offer a letter to express our deepest love and concern for you and your family. May God be your refuge, your strength, and a very pleasant help in your hour of bereavement. In closing, I want to let the family take the verse hymn. Be not dismayed. Whenever we tie, God will take care of you. With loving thoughts and sympathy. Amen. Don't grieve for me, for now I am free. I followed the plan God laid for me, and I saw his face. I heard his call. I took his hand, and I left all I could. Stay another day to love, to laugh, to work, and to play. Tasks left undone must stay that way. If my parting has left you a void, then fill it with remembering joy. A friendship shared, a laugh, a kiss, and yes, things I do shall miss. My life has been full. Good times, good friends, and loved ones. Perhaps my time seems to be all brief, but shorten yours and undo grief. Do not be bothered with tears of sorrow. Enjoy the sunshine of tomorrow. Whereas in the sight of God is the death of the saints. Psalms 116:15. And thou shalt love the Lord, thy God be in thy heart, and with all thy soul and all thy might. Deuteronomy 6:5. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Whatsoever believed in him should not perish, but everlasting life. John 3:16. Minister Darrin Bruton loved God as a will worker of Christ. His very presence and true love displayed and produced an attitude of faith in ministry. Minister Bruton displayed by his excelling and uplifting his leaders, respecting his leaders, kept watch while his leaders rest. He demonstrated extreme loyalty. He was one who had his leaders back at all times, one who was willing to sacrifice his own needs and comfort to help his pastor achieve his goal. To the family, Minister Bruton will receive an ultimate destination of the universe. We state that he has departed, but God has said he has arrived. God sees things from such a different perspective than we do. God never sees his children die. He simply sees them coming home. We know that your loss is deep and your sorrow is great. We want you to know that we share your sorrow, but more importantly, we recognize that this loss is a heavenly gain. The Judah Temple of Deliverance extends and sincere sympathy and will be praying for you during your time of healing. May God bless you and keep you in his heart. To be resolved, it is a resolution to give into the family of Minister Darrin Bruton, humbly and prayerfully submitting on this fourth day of January 2020. Bishop Anthony Myers. Thank you.
Is coming momentarily.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. We're going to move forward just at this moment, but we're going to come back. Amen. We want you to be able to see that wonderful production. Amen. And to see it correctly. So you're going to bring it back so that you can see it and hear it at a later time. But while you read the life reflections, I'm going to share with you the acknowledgments. And the acknowledgments reads, the family of Darrin the Unruly would like to take the time to acknowledge Willie A. Watkins from all homes for their wonderful and professional service during this time of need. The family also acknowledges Tabernacle Baptist Church, Rehoboth Church of Atlanta, and Pastor Troy Sanders for the use of their church facility. The family would like to also thank City of Chapin's Full Gospel Church for their heartfelt commitment to the family during this time of need by providing services and support. We would also like to thank OJ Branded Food, there we go, for the food donation. Thank you, Christopher Morrell, for your amazing program designs. Listen to everyone that played a part in these services and in this celebration on behalf of this family. Thank you for showing up, especially to these leaders. Thank you for the way that you've rallied around this leader and this ministry during their time of bereavement, especially our family. We're going to receive Lady Carol Marshall, who's going to come and she's going to render our selection. And after that, we'll receive the PowerPoint again. And then after that, we'll be in hands of Pastor Jonathan Marshall. Amen. Won't you receive it this time? First Lady Carol Marshall. Thank you.
In the 7 years that I pastored Darrin, Brandy Marshall, raise your hand, Brandy. Brandy Marshall brought Darrin to the church. A church that's cold for everybody who had just left. I was devastated. I said, well, maybe we should shut down because I don't know if God called me to do this. And Darrin came in the door. He was growing his dreads then. And he said, now, man of God. And the truth, you know, people get up at these kind of services and they lie, but I don't have to lie about Darrin. I preach.
Come on, Pastor.
You know, people do it. My mama, I got a good teacher. She said people get up at their funerals and do all that show open, but just check my page. I preach all over the country. And I can name one engagement that I've been in 7 years that Darrin didn't go with me. We would go places, y'all, and sometimes I wouldn't be saying much of nothing. I didn't have nothing in the car on the way to church. And he'd be over there, preach, man of God. I said, Darrin, I ain't talking about nothing. One time he told me in the car, say, you give me $25, I start to break off. I said, get out the car and shit, boy. We have board meetings. You can be seated in the presence of the Lord. I'ma hurry up. We have board meetings. And the truth of the matter is, it's not love if it's not been tested. Mm-hmm. It has to be tested in order for it to be love. His mind regardless. He was clear that everybody in the church might be scared of me, but I ain't scared of him. Mm-hmm. He would say, now, Pastor, you turned us again. I said, how so, Darrin? You told us that the fee was $125. How I got to $225? I said, I changed my mind. He said, here we go. Darrin was a sounding board. You can tell him anything, and you wouldn't hear it again. There were times, I know y'all don't know about it, but if you're in a real relationship, sometimes you don't get along with your significant other. Mm-hmm. And me and my wife got in a knockout drag out in front of, we didn't fight now. We was arguing towards each other, and Darrin sat in the back seat and he didn't open his mouth. We got in the store and he walked up behind me. He said, you okay, Pastor? I said, I'm okay. And the next thing I know, him and Kara was walking down the shop mall, and I low-key, he took her side because he was treating me mean for the rest of the day. He said, I'll put your water over there. Love, Darrin. Go to Isaiah 57. I love Jesus.
Yes, Pastor.
He is my Savior. When storms are raging, he's my shelter. Wherever he leads me, I will follow. Cause I love Jesus. And he loves. I love Jesus. He is my Savior. When storms are raging, he'll be my shelter. Wherever he leads me, I will follow. Cause I love Jesus. And he loves. I love the Lord, and I will take you back. This is Troy. I love the Lord, and I won't take you back. I don't agree with your decision, but I love the Lord, and I won't take you back. He has been so good to me. We might as well do it. He's been so good.
Last Sunday I went to the house. First I want to tell y'all that I felt some type of way against God. I felt some type of way because I asked God, I said, why do you always take the good ones and leave the hell raisers? You ain't got to like it. He was at my church. You didn't have to look for Darrin. You didn't have to ask Darrin to pay his tithes. You didn't ask Darrin for his dues or whatever. Darrin was a server. So I said, God, why did you take the good ones and leave up the ones that keep up some foolishness? I felt some type of way. I was talking to my wife. Y'all can keep playing with this song. I was talking to my wife and I said, why didn't I see this? Now, Darrin was in control at all times. He had no strength, but he was yelling at us. I went to the house to see about him last Sunday after church. And he said, I saw y'all all over the city and just getting here to see about me at 8 o'clock. Care of my life. I said, Darrin, I'm starving you. I went to go touch him. He said, no, Pastor, your hand's too rough. He said, Lady K, can you come rub my back? I said, absolutely. I got out the room. I came back. He said, Pastor, I got to use the bathroom. So I said, Carol, we'll step out so he can use the bathroom. He said, no, Lady K, you go. Pastor, you stay. Carol got out the room, and he got up. He was trying to get off the bed, and it took him a couple of minutes to rock, to get his strength together. Mm-hmm. He was rocking on that bed. On the little TV, he had preaching and all that stuff going on there, okay? And he was sitting on the bed, and while he was sitting on the bed, I went to go lift him up. He said, no. He said, do this for me. He said, if you get me up, I can do the rest. Darrin preached his own eulogy today because he said to me, he said, Pastor, if you get me up, I can do the rest. Mm-hmm. So he was leaning on my shoulders, and he would always ask me, he said, how you look? I said, boy, you look so good. He said, Pastor, you lying to me? I said, boy, you look amazing. I got him off the bed, and he walked in the bathroom by himself. And it was a sign that a couple of weeks ago that he wasn't eating, but he was holding foods again. And so we was in the room giving God praise for progress. Mm-hmm. The thing about this, Apostle Thomas, and this is the eulogy. The thing about this, I missed it. And sometimes we prophetic people get angry with God.
So come on, Pastor.
Slipped on out of here. I said, Carol, I said, why? Never talk to me. She said, because you're a bully sometimes. I was grieving. I looked up at her and I said, watch it. She said, you're a bully sometimes. And she said, if Darrin would have told you he was tired, you wouldn't have accepted him. I know. You got to know the City of Champions and other dynamics in the room. Mm-hmm. And that room was founded on prayer. And so before we consult with the doctor, you go into the doctor, but we believe the report of the Lord.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
So Carol said, if Darrin had to say to me, and I'm done, y'all keep playing that because we're going to rejoice on out of here, that he wanted to leave, you would not have accepted it. So he didn't say nothing. He was mourning Sydney. He was mad. He was sad that his feet were swollen. He was sad that he couldn't go like he wanted to go. He was sad that his money was wrapping up. And the only outcome that I had was, is God was going to raise you up. Mm-hmm. And the truth of the matter is, God kept his part of the contract. I said God raised him up, and God said I did.
Come on.
Wow. I said, God, why didn't you allow Darrin to be healed on this side? And the Holy Spirit said this to me, take it, leave it, whatever. He said, Darrin had a choice. He said, I showed Darrin what was on the other side. And I let Darrin choose, did he want to come back here? Or did he want to go there? I was in my room and I was crying this morning before the service. I was crying because it was a special kind of connection. You have to understand a pastor's relationship with his member and his friend and all these other stuff. And I was praying this morning, and I thought about it all service long, that Darrin wouldn't come back if he had the choice.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's not in pain no more. Nobody don't have to sit him up. Darrin is not alone no more. And so I have solemn in the fact that Darrin won.
All right.
bed doing church anniversary. I went to go see about him because, again, he was controlling. Mm-hmm. I went to go see about Darrin. He was in the hospital room, and he scared me so bad because Darrin yelled at you. I yelled back, no, be confused. But Darrin would yell at you, so I took people to see him in the hospital, but I ran in that room first to ask, was it okay? Mm-hmm. Because Darrin would turn you right back around. I went in that room. I said, Darrin, I brought all the preachers that came on the lineup. Is that okay? He said, put my gown up on me and comb my hair down. And he said, put something in my mouth. And so I was putting my wash in his mouth and I was cleaning his teeth off and stuff like that. And he started crying. I said, we ain't got time for all that. Our visitors are outside. Come on, fix up. Come on, get up. And when they all left, I went back to go tell him. He said, Pastor, I'll never miss another anniversary as long as I live. I said, that promise you made to me, so next year, you coming back to anniversary. And I don't believe that Darrin broke his promise. I believe that some people have to transition so other people can come. Mm-hmm. And so what I want to say to you, Darrin, today is I did not turn you, as you would say. I didn't embarrass you. But I want to say thank you for your service. Mm-hmm. Thank you for wiping my tears. Thank you for knowing Jonathan and Pastor Marshall and never leaving that church. Thank you for lifting my hands up when my hands were heavy. Thank you for lifting my hands up. Thank you for giving me a family within the City of Champions Full Gospel Church. And what I want to say to you is, Darrin, that you were so correct. I helped you up so you can do the rest. Enjoy it. Can we just send Darrin home with a praise? Can we just send Darrin home with a praise? Can we just send Darrin home with a praise? You don't have to make no big fuss. But if you want to go to heaven, you got to be saved. I don't care what new theology that they come up with. All I know is apostolism, and you got to know Jesus if you're going to hell. Oh. Even if you don't believe in hell, it's that you're going somewhere. If you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, I admonish you to get to know him. He's a savior. And there is nothing that you have done that he will reject you, that he will put you out. He's the lover of my soul. The truth of the matter is, the truth of the matter is, I've done enough not to stand up here. But it was grace and mercy. My past is not impeccable. If you Google my name, you might find out some stuff about me that I would prefer that you don't know. But the truth of the matter is, he goes to the garbage can, but he don't keep garbage. Garments when he found me, but I'm glad he knows how to do collectibles. He went to the thrift store and I was still wearable. He went to Goodwill and I was still cleaner upable. And he washed me and gave me his spirit. And I said to the Lord, and I'm dying because this is the altar call. And I said to the Lord, I said, send me the people that nobody wants. Y'all gonna look at me funny, that's why nobody won't go to your church. I said, send me the people that nobody want to be bothered with. I said, send me the people that everybody deems unclean and unworthy. And I said, I'll do something with them. Darrin walked by me and I was unapologetic about it. If you didn't accept me, you didn't accept Darrin. If you didn't accept Darrin, you didn't accept me. Because I said, God, send me the people that nobody else wants. And the truth of the matter is, he still saves. Everybody lift your hands. Musicians, stay right there. Lord Jesus, we're sinners, and we want to be saved. Come into our hearts, oh God. Wash us, purge us, make us applicable and pliable to your will. We want to meet you in peace, oh God. We want to hear you say, well done, that good and faithful servant. We've been faithful of a few things, and now you're going to make us the ruler over many. Now, Father, I thank you for his life. I thank you for every life that's here today. And I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus that when the music is over and when we have gone back to our own destinations that you take us through, you told us that you were a current help
life at the time of trouble. You told us that you would lift up every bowed down head. And so, Father, we thank you in the name of the Lord Jesus that you're going to take us through this. Thank you that this is not our end, but this is our beginning. And you shall do a new thing, and behold, shall it spring forth. Thank you, oh God, that you give us second chances. Thank you that you loved us when we were unlovable. Thank you, oh God, that you cleaned us up. Now, Father, for the rest of our life, we'll serve you. Save these your people. And we'll give you glory. We'll give you honor. We'll give you praise.
The PowerPoint is a no. Mm-hmm. We just wanted you to know that Darrin was a praiser. Undertake this.
except the immediate family. Now, Father, for what our eyes have seen, for what our ears have heard, especially for what our hearts have received, there's nothing left to do but to say thank you. Thank you for your peace. Thank you for your strength.